A very good morning, friends. Today's topic of discussion is iron. It is a LAQ in university exam, and you may get a case on iron deficiency anemia. Iron is a trace element because requirement of iron is less than 100 milligram per day. Total iron contained in body is 3 to 5 gram. Of this, 75% of iron, it is present in hemoglobin. So iron is an important constituent of hemoglobin. Other proteins which contain iron, they are myoglobin, then cytochromes, then iron sulfur proteins, cytochrome P450, some enzymes that includes catalase, peroxidase, xanthine oxidase and tryptophan pyrolase. So these are important compounds which contain iron. Now coming to the important functions of iron related to these compounds, as it is present in hemoglobin, the main role of iron in our body is to transport oxygen to the tissues and carbon dioxide to the lung. This is the important function of iron in our body. Apart from that, in myoglobin, then cytochromes and iron sulfur proteins, they are involved in the cellular respiration, that means electron transport chain. Cytochrome P450, it is involved in the detoxification process. Catalase, peroxidase, they are important as a antioxidants. Xanthine oxidase, it is involved in the purine degradation. Tryptophan pyrolase, it is important in tryptophan metabolism. So these are the important functions of iron in our body. Now coming to the RDA, recommended daily allowance of iron. For adult male, it is 10 milligram. For menstruating female, it is 20 milligram, and it is 40 milligram in case of pregnancy and lactation. Demand also increases in growing children. It is near about 10 to 20 milligram per day. Coming to the sources of iron, the important source of iron is green leafy vegetables. Leafy vegetables, it contain near about 20 milligram per 100 gram. Then cereals and pulses. Pulses, it contain 10 milligram per 100 gram of cereals, 5 milligram per 100 gram. Then jaggery, it is an important source of iron. Then liver and meat. Liver contain 5 milligram per 100 gram and meat contain 2 milligram per 100 gram. These are the important sources of iron. Then it is also present in dry fruits, beetroot. Then milk is a poor source of iron. It contains 0.1 milligram per 100 ml of milk. So it is a poor source of iron. Now coming to the absorption, transport and storage of iron. Absorption, transport and storage. Iron present in food in the ferric form. It is converted into ferrous form. This ferrous form get absorbed into a intestinal mucosal cell with the help of protein. The name of that protein is divalent metal ion transporter 1. With the help of this protein, iron get absorbed into the intestinal mucosal cell, and intestinal mucosal cell, this iron is converted into ferric form with the help of ferroxidase, and it gets stored in the intestinal mucosal cell as ferritin. It condenses with apoferritin, get converted into ferritin. Ferritin is a storage form of iron in the intestinal mucosal cell, liver, spleen and bone marrow. Now this ferric form, with the help of ferroreductase, it is converted into ferrous form and transported out of intestinal mucosal cell with the help of protein known as ferroportin. It is in the plasma now. In the plasma, this ferrous is converted into ferric form with the help of ceruloplasmin, which has ferroxidase activity. Now this ferrous condenses with apotransferrin and it get converted into transferrin, which is a transport form of iron in the blood or plasma. Now this transferrin, iron from this transferrin, it is utilized in the enzyme cytochromes, cytochrome P450, hemoglobin, myoglobin, and remaining part of iron gets stored in the liver, bone marrow, spleen in the form of ferritin. So this is a storage form of iron, and also hemosiderin, it is also a storage form of iron. The regulation of iron level is done at the level of this mucosa, that is known as mucosal block theory. Mucosal block theory. When demand increases, absorption increases. When demand decreases, absorption decreases, which is at the mucosal level. That's why it is known as mucosal block theory. And hepcidin, it is a protein which downregulates the level of divalent metal ion transporter and ferroportin. It is important in the regulation of iron at the mucosal level. Iron is known as one-way substance, one-way element or substance, because there is very less excretion of iron through the bile, sweat and hair loss. less than 1 milligram per day iron loss through the body. That's why it is known as one way element. It is utilized and reutilized again and again. That's why it is known as one way element. Now coming to the deficiency manifestations of iron or diseases which are related to the iron. The important disease and most common disease in developing country is the iron deficiency anemia. Iron deficiency anemia. Causes of iron deficiency anemia includes increased demand and decreased intake. Then chronic blood loss, as in ulcer or hookworm infection, there is chronic blood loss. Also there is blood loss in postpartum period. So increased demand, decreased intake, chronic blood loss, then lead, that causes the iron deficiency anemia. The important cause of iron deficiency is repeated pregnancies. Symptoms include two important symptoms. The first one is the apathy. Apathy means sluggish and dull child. There is decreased school performance, fatigue, weakness in the deficiency of iron. This is the first important symptom of iron deficiency. Second is the anemia. That is microcytic hypochromic anemia. These are the important manifestations of iron deficiency. There is atrophy of mucosal and gastric mucosa, that is known as achlorhydria, and also it is known as Plummer-Wilson syndrome. But these are the important manifestations of iron deficiency. Laboratory investigations include lab diagnosis, serum iron level, which decreases in the iron deficiency anemia. Second, total iron binding capacity, which is near about 400 microgram per deciliter. This is the iron binding capacity, means capacity of binding iron to the transferrin. The transferrin normal level is 250 milligram per deciliter. So TIBC level in the iron deficiency anemia increases. Then hemoglobin, this is the general routine investigation. In case of male, it is 14 to 16 gram per DL. In case of female, it is 13 to 15 gram per deciliter. So hemoglobin level decreases. In iron deficiency anemia, serum iron level decreases, TIBC increases, and hemoglobin level decreases. Two important diseases which are related to the iron, excess of iron, that includes hemosiderosis and hemochromatosis. Hemosiderosis. Here there is excess iron due to increased absorption of iron. It is typically found in Bantu tribes of South Africa. That's why it is known as Bantu siderosis. And second condition is hemochromatosis. In this condition, there is excess of iron and it get deposited in skin, bone marrow, liver, spleen. Deposition under the skin, it gives yellow to brown coloration, and that is known as bronze coloration. Bronze coloration to the skin. The combination of hemochromatosis, diabetes, and cirrhosis of liver, diabetes mellitus, and hemochromatosis, it is known as bronze diabetes. So this is all about the iron. Hope you understood the iron. Keep watching. Thank you.